Hi my dear children, students, parents and my dear friends, welcome back to your channel. Hey Kalpana ma'am, and in this today's 5 minutes video we're going to cover two types of pronouns. The first type in the previous video we already covered, that is personal pronoun. Now this time we're going to cover two. One is reflexive pronoun and the other is, third one is emphatic pronoun. The reason why we are going to learn about two things at a time is because they have some common things. Got it? You need to know what thing to be followed in which pronoun. So that's the reason. So if you do these two together, you'll be able to differentiate. That will help you in differentiating these two kinds of pronouns. Okay? So in today's 5 minutes video, you're going to learn reflexive pronoun as well as emphatic pronoun. This is second and third. What did you learn? Second and third kind we are going to, third type we are going to read. First is personal pronoun, which is already done. Second is reflexive pronoun and then third is emphatic pronoun. Okay, it's very easy. Trust me, you can do it. Okay, so your time starts now. So the two kinds are reflexive pronoun and emphatic pronoun. Okay, dear? Before going to reflexive as well as emphatic pronoun, you need to know one thing, that is self words. What are the self words? When I say self word, you should know what word goes. What is the self word? What self word do I mean? Okay. So you know the. We all know the pronouns, right? Isn't it? Yeah. I, he, she, you, we, they, it, right? So when it comes to I becomes myself. I becomes myself. He becomes himself. She becomes herself. You become yourself. It becomes itself. Children, have you noticed one thing here? Can you see the word self? Right? Isn't it? Self. Wherever S-E-L-F, S-E-L-F, S-E-L-F is being added to, as a suffix it's been added, those are singular. Those are used for singular. Okay, got it here? Okay, for singular pronouns we use these. But when you talk about plural pronouns, that is we and they, then S-E-L-F, do you see S-E-L-F? F will change to VES. F will change to VES. You need to remove the S, F, and replace it with VES. Okay, let's see. So, when it comes to singular pronoun, what all will come in singular pronoun? I, he, she, you, and it. I, he, she, you. You, when you're pointing out at one person. That you I'm saying. Okay? Not you all. You, one person. So I, he, she, you, and it. These are singular personal pronouns. These are singular pronouns. See, singular pronouns where the self becomes, takes, it gets added as a suffix to these. I will become myself, he will become himself, she will become herself, you will become yourself, S-E-L-F, it will become itself. Okay, now let's see some plural pronouns. You, previously we saw you, right, isn't it? That you, what was the S-E-L-F word? That was you, yourself, S-E-L-F. But now here, you has become, what did I say? F, when it's, see, I look at the mirror, I see only me in the mirror. So I say yourself. But when I talk to you all, so you all means more than one. Then S-E-L-F, F will get replaced to V-E-S, V-E-S, see, S gets, F gets replaced to V-E-S, S-E-L-F was there, F got replaced and it got replaced with V-E-S. So if it's more than one and you're using you for more than one, so you will become yourselves, yourselves. So do not get confused, Y-O-U or S-E-L-F will come or S-E-L-V-E-S will come. If you mean only one person, then yourself is correct. Correct. There you can't use VES. If you use VES, then it's wrong. But if you actually mean more than one, then SELF is wrong. And it has to be SELVES. Correct. Got it here? Huh? Okay, next. We will come ourselves. We means two, more than two, more than one. So obviously F will get replaced to VES. Ourself will become ourselves. Right? Okay. They will become themselves. So when I say F, when I say self word, that means you should know. If it's more than one, I have to add VES. Got it? I don't need to segregate and say that you have to self's word. I will not say. I'll just say self word. You should understand. For plural, it has to be F will get replaced with VES, that is selves. SELVES. And for singular, where there's only one, then SELF will come. Got it, dear? Okay, so now that you know this, you'll be able to do a reflexive pronoun easily, very easily. Trust me, children, just be with me. Okay, see, reflexive pronoun. For singular, SELF will come. And for plural, SELVES will come. We have already seen it, right? Isn't it? Huh? So, a singular or plural self word. Self word means, you know, all these words which we saw. Okay. A singular or plural self word used after a verb. Verb is what? Action. Verb is what? Action. Action. That's what is a verb. Isn't it? Huh? So, a self word, it can be myself, it can be yourself, it can be ourself. Right? It can be itself. That self word used after a verb, after an action, is called a reflexive pronoun. Is called a reflexive pronoun. Let's see through example. Okay. I. If you're talking about one person. I. We have given example of all seven here. Okay. I hurt myself. So there is, this is self word. Can you see the self word, children? Myself is a self word. Right? But it has been added. It comes after what? After the action. I hurt myself. Immediately after the verb. Immediately after the action. The self word follows. Got it? I hurt myself. I hurt myself. Got it? Huh? Now he. He will become. He will become himself. Isn't it? So he hurt himself. Again, himself is coming after what? After the action hurt. After the action hurt, himself is coming. That's the self word. Now, she. She means herself. Right? So, again, she hurt herself. She hurt herself. Where? After what is herself word? The self word. Herself is followed. After an action. Hurt. After the action hurt. Okay. You hurt yourself. Hurt is an action, right? It's a verb. We hurt ourselves. They hurt themselves. We hurt ourselves. We means more than one. We, yes, see? You should know. By now you would have understood when to use SELF and when to use SELVES, right? Isn't it? So they hurt themselves. It hurt itself. Got it? Got it, dear? So this is what is a reflexive pronoun. The simple pronoun thing, Fanta, you need to remember is, what is reflexive pronoun? The self word. Now you know SELF where and SELVES where to use, right? Isn't it? So the self word followed immediately after the verb. Self word after a verb. That's what is a reflexive pronoun. Got it, children? See, hurt. What hurt is what? It's a reflexive. It's an action. It's an action. Got it, dear? Is that clear? I hope you got it, children. Now, next. Now, let's see. Emphatic pronoun. Emphatic pronoun. Here, only one thing you need to remember. That the self word. Again, same self word. Okay? The self word should follow after the subject. After the subject. Not action. Here, action doesn't come. What you need to remember? That self word should follow immediately after the subject. Subject means what? Person pronoun. I, he, she, you, we, they. Correct? Isn't it, dear? Hmm? I, he, she, you, we, they is the personal pronoun. Okay? Hmm? Now see. Emphatic pronoun. A singular or plural self word, that is singular as self. Yourself, myself, she, herself, himself. And plural self word is ourselves, themselves. Okay? Hmm? A singular or plural self word used after the subject. But when it was reflexive, it was after the verb. After the verb. Now it's after the subject. That changes the meaning in a sentence. It's called a reflexive pronoun. See, I. You know how to use myself, right? But the self word comes after what? Hurt is an action. It's a verb. I is a subject. I myself hurt. See, I myself hurt. That was no one else hurt me. I myself, I hurt. Got it? Huh? See, I is what? Subject. He is what? Subject. So, self word is immediately after the subject. It's not after the verb or action. Got it? It's immediately after the subject. She hurt her. She herself hurt. You yourself hurt. Don't blame it on me. You yourself hurt. Got it? Huh? We ourselves hurt. Please don't scold him. We ourselves, we hurt. Okay? Huh? They themselves hurt. It itself hurt. Got it, dear? So only one thing you need to remember is in reflexive pronoun, the self word comes immediately after the action. Got it? Huh? Okay, huh? But when it comes to emphatic pronoun, the self word is followed immediately after the subject. Let it be I, she, you, we, they, it, whatever it is. Immediately after the subject, that will get, the self word will come. Got it, dear? And you know which is the self word. You know very well. So by now you would have understood. So only, let me give you a quick recap, children. When it comes to self word, only for singulars, singular nouns, singular pronouns, we use SELF. More than one, F changes to VES. So self will become selves. So you, yourself and yourselves do not get confused. Both are correct. But you should know when to use where. Got it? Which one to use where, you need to know. When you say you and you mean only one person, then yourself will come, SELF. But when you say you all, that more than one, then yourself will become yourselves. Got it? So that's the thing. And when it comes to plural, again, we will become ourselves and they will become themselves. Got it, dear? Hmm? So a reflexive pronoun is what? What happens? The self word is followed immediately after the action. Okay? Huh? And when it comes to emphatic pronoun, the self word is followed immediately after the subject. I, he, she, you, we, they. Got it, dear? So that's what is reflexive pronoun and emphatic pronoun. I hope by now you would have got it, children. Right? Isn't it? So it's very easy, very simple. Okay. So first one we already done. That is personal pronoun. These are the second one. That is reflexive pronoun and emphatic pronoun. The third one. Okay. So that's what is the second and third pronoun, dear, and we are sorted. So very simple, very simple. Just follow the thing. Subject, after subject, if the self word comes, then that is emphatic. Even immediately after the action, if the self word is followed, then that is reflexive. Okay? Okay, children, have a great day. Bye-bye. Bye, children.